file na sa Pasig Court yung human trafficking?
Yes, the DOJ would like to confirm that the case against Alice Guo, including Dennis Cunanan, who is a former Technology and Livelihood Resource Center Deputy Director General and Representative Zun Yuan Technology, as well as 12 executives and founders of the three companies and Guo's alleged business partners, has been filed in the Regional Trial Court of Pasig City. Initially po, if a file na sana dahil yung jurisdiction po talaga ng kaso, dahil doon naganap yung krimen, ay nasa Capas Tarlac. However, dahil po sa linabas na administrative circular ng Supreme Court, na ilipat ho natin sa Pasig City. And all relevant and relative cases to those filed are also going to be filed now in Pasig City Regional Trial Court.
Sir, paano iniintay yung arrest warrant, and if and when, paano yung magiging custody kay Alice Guo?
Well, the court will have to make their own judicial determination of probable cause. And kung mahanap nila ang probable cause, mag-i-issue na po sila ng isang warrant of arrest. Now, yung mga cases po na ito ay non-bailable, which is why as soon as the warrants of arrest are out from the Pasig Trial Court, then we can expect to take custody of Ms. Alice Guo, despite or if ever she is released already from Senate, and if ever she does decide na mag-bail siya doon sa Capas Tarlac, doon sa isang kaso niya.
Pero sir, yun sa custody, hindi naman magkaka-problem. May Senate arrest warrant, and nasa PNP siya.
Well, nag-set na po kasi ang Senate ng last hearing regarding yung sa kaso ni Alice Guo. Kaya we can expect after that, there is a possibility that she will already be released from the Senate's custody. Now, there is still a pending warrant of arrest for former Mayor Alice Guo doon sa Capas Tarlac for the graft and corruption case filed by the Ombudsman. But we are also anticipating that at any time after the determination of probable cause by the court, na maglabas na rin ng warrant of arrest itong Pasig City RTC.
Parang pwede siyang walang arrest warrant na in effect at pwedeng makawala siya?
Well, the DOJ has no jurisdiction over the courts to determine yung timing po no ng pag-release or pag-issue ng warrant of arrest. Of course, it would be in our favor na hindi siya makawala. So we do hope na these warrants of arrest are issued in such a timely manner para wala na pong interregnum or interruption dun sa custody ni former Mayor Alice Guo.
Sir, may plan din ba na kasuhan yung lawyer nga na nag-notarize ng kanyang counter affidavit? Kasi lumalabas nga dun sa Senate hearing kahapon na hindi talaga siya kubarap, and then apparently even yung mga lawyers, sinasabi ng senator, mukhang alam din na yung kanilang client ay tataka sa alis ng bansa.
Well, we are still studying no the possibility of filing cases as may be necessary by the circumstances and facts na ni-reveal doon sa Senate hearing. However, wala pang naka-file, but siguro isang paalala lang din to sa mga abogado na nagno-notarize na hindi naman po pwede na kahit absent po yung magsuswear in, ay pwedeng mag-notarize pa din. In fact, nakasulat doon sa affidavit na sworn before me. Diba? So, dapat physically present po yung affiant. Kaya, of course, kung may mahanap tayo na irregularity doon sa pag-notarize ng dokumento, then all those that are responsible will be held accountable.
Sir, timetable lang doon sa iba pang undergoing PI ngayon, yung tax evasion and monitoring, kailan natin i-expect na may ka-file na rin sa court?
Well, I have yet to get a report. However, the panel of prosecutors are on top of it. Siguro, hinihintay pa nila yung mga counter-affidavits of all those respondents that are included in the complaint. But as soon as they are able to submit their counter-affidavits and the same is submitted for resolution, then we can expect na within a few days or weeks na mailabas na po yung resolution.
Sir, kamusta yung naging meeting nyo kanina for the Pogo closure?
Okay naman, dapat kasi mag-regular meeting talaga lahat ng stakeholders dito sa closure ng Pogo, no? So, kailangan lahat ng efforts po natin ay coordinated, lalo na may mga empleyado yan na may hawak na aliens permit to work here in the Philippines. meron din tayong mga immigration issues that we have to iron out. Kaya maganda na lang na regular po ang ating mga meetings sa mga stakeholders.
Sir, pwede ibang topic? Yung kay Tevez lang, sir. Baka pwede pong ma-clarify lang yung issue na yun.
Well, what happened in the Tevez case, the extradition case in Timor-Leste, basically, yung kampo po nila Ginoong Tevez, kinontest po yung procedural matters. No? Ang nangyari dun sa first decision, ang nag-receive ng evidence ay isang justice lamang, no, sa Court of Appeals. But it was decided by all three justices. What they contest and what they are arguing is that the receipt of evidence should have been done by the three justices who eventually decided on the case. So it's a very minor, very, very minor procedural lapse that they are trying to allege. Pero pinagbigyan po ng Timor-Leste Court of Appeals because they want to cure this procedural lapse to make sure po no, na ang magiging decision nila ay full force at valid. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, kung dito nangyari yun, they would have been stopped from contesting this procedural matter on the doctrine of estoppel. Estopped sana sila dahil nag-participate naman sila, nagbigay naman sila ng evidence, ng testimony, assuming that all the procedures were valid. Ngayon po na natalo sila doon sa first decision, that is the only time that they thought na i-contest or i-question yung procedure na dinaanan nila. Hindi po yan pwede dito sa Pilipinas. Meron po tayong general principle of law na ang tawag natin estoppel. If somebody actively participates in a process without yet questioning the procedure, cannot anymore contest the procedure after a decision has been rendered. Lalo na dito, adverse po sa kanila. So, kami po, we will just stay patient, lalo na participant po tayo, party lang po tayo sa isang kaso sa ibang bansa, but we are very confident na parehas pa din ang magiging desisyon ng Court of Appeals. Dahil po, sila na rin, tatlo, ang nag-decide doon sa first decision. The only thing that they are contesting is that one justice received the evidence, which is a very, very minor procedural defect that they are contesting.
So, sir, hindi nullified yung earlier decision? And ano tawag nga, sir, ba? Retrial ba ito? Or how do we qualify that?
Well, they are going to be able to present their evidence again to the three justices. It's going to be the same process. They will probably have the same evidence, have the same testimonies, and dito rin sa amin, parehas lang din ang gagawin namin. Kaya, we do not see the decision straying away from the first.
So, paano yung, sir, nullified ba?
Well, I wouldn't say nullified. They are just trying to cure a procedural defect, a very minor procedural defect. Well, that will depend on how long also the justices will take to decide on the case.